similarity matrix, that is cosine distance. Cosine distance. Why we need cosine distance? Cosine distance is basically used to measure the similarity between two documents or dissimilarity between two documents. How two documents are similar to each other, how they are different than each other's. So before going to the cosine distance calculations, we will first understand what is cosine similarity. Understanding the math and how it works. Cosine similarity is a metric used to measure how similar the documents are, irrespective of their sizes. It means a document may consist of 10 pages, another document may consist of 100 pages. That doesn't matter for cosine similarity. What matters is the angle that are present between two documents. Okay, so that angle will be calculated by using cosine distance. So cosine similarity is a metric used to measure how similar the documents are, irrespective of their sizes. Mathematically, it measures the cosine of the angles between two vectors projected in multidimensional space. Always remember, the cosine distance works in 2D space or 3D space, where we need to calculate the angle between two different vectors. And that angle will be called as cosine angle. Cosine similarity is an advantage. It's advantageous because even if two dissimilar documents are far apart by the Euclidean distance due to the size of the documents, chances are they may still be oriented closer to each other with the help of cosine similarity. So the size, if the size of the document increases, the number of common words into the both the documents also increases. So that's why the angle may gets wider, right? So because of that, the distance may be more into that. Now remember, always the sentence that is in the quotation mark and it is kept bold. That is, the smaller the angle of cosine, the higher is the cosine similarity. It means the angle of between two vectors should be very less. Then we can say that they are more similar documents. Under the introduction of this cosine distance, a commonly used approach to match two similar documents is based on counting the maximum number of common words between the documents. It means if I want to check whether two documents are more common or not, I will calculate how many words in both the documents are common. But this approach has an inherent flaw, that is, as the size of the document increases, the number of common words also increases. That tends to increase even if the documents talk about the different topics. They may not be talking about the similar topic, they may be talking about different topics also. So in that scenario, if the size increases, then the common words also increases. The cosine similarity helps overcome this flaw, fundamental flaw, in the count the common words or Euclidean distance approach. So it is definitely different than the Euclidean distance approach. What is cosine similarity and why it is advantageous for us? Cosine similarity is a metric used to determine how similar the documents are, irrespective of their sizes. Mathematically, it measures the cosine of the angle between two vectors projected in multidimensional space. In the context, the two vectors I'm talking about are arrays containing the words counts of two documents. It means whenever you represent two documents in an examination also, they will give you two vectors. They will give, going to give you two vectors, maybe A and another is B. A in square bracket, they are going to give you some numbers, and that number represents the word count or you can say frequency count of every word into the document. As a similarity metric, how does cosine similarity differs from the number of common words? When plotted on a multidimensional space, where each dimension corresponds to one word in the document, the cosine similarity captures the orientation angle of the documents and do not consider the magnitude of the words. If you want the magnitude calculated, then you'll prefer equidistant distance for that. So always remember that cosine similarity only focuses on the number of common words into each document. The cosine similarity is advantageous because even if the two dissimilar documents are far apart by the equidistant distance because of their sizes, they could still have a similar or smaller angle between them with the help of cosine similarity. To understand this, we'll consider an example of two documents, two or more than two documents, where there are certain text inside the document, where there are certain common words inside the document, and our job is to find which two documents are more similar to each other. Now suppose three documents with you, which consist of the information of couple of stars, star cricket players, such as Sachin Tendulkar, Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Two of the documents A and B are from the Wikipedia pages on the respective players' information. I'll show you the first document, which has the information of Sachin Tendulkar. This is a Wikipedia page which gives you the information of the cricket player Sachin Tendulkar, right? And then another document is about the Mahendra Singh Dhoni. The another page talks about the information on Mahendra Singh Dhoni. Okay, now we'll consider one more document just for our understanding. We'll take one more document which is a subpart of this document. Suppose Mahendra Singh Dhoni's page subpart is, suppose it is having 4 or 5 pages into the whole document. Consider there are so many pages here, and your third document consists of only this page, first page, right? So we have three documents in our hand now. One is giving you the information of Sachin Tendulkar, another is giving the information of Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and third is gives you the information of the first page of the Mahendra Singh Dhoni's Wikipedia page, only this particular page. Okay, now suppose I want to find the cosine similarity between these three documents, how they are similar, how they are dissimilar. I will look for common words in both the documents. When you compare two documents, you need to check for common words in both the documents. Now consider which are those words. Now I'll write into the chat box, this notepad. The words are, first word is Sachin. The document must consist of Sachin. Next, the document consists of Dhoni. And third word should be cricket. So when you apply your machine learning algorithm for searching these particular words into the documents, you will get the count, right? You'll get some count. And at the end, what you come to know is the number of times the words are matching in Wikipedia page of Sachin Tendulkar and Mahendra Singh Dhoni. The cosine similarity for these two documents is definitely less than the cosine similarity of the second document, that is Mahendra Singh Dhoni's complete Wikipedia page, and the snapshot of the first page, your third document, right? Where the similarity would be more because the second and third page, so second and third document, are related to Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So the number of times the words Sachin, Dhoni and cricket, that will come in second document and third documents more number of times. That's why the cosine similarity angle will be less, and that's why the cosine similarity is more between second and third document. Now to understand this more thoroughly, I'll give an example. In your examination, they may give you two vectors like this and ask you to find the cosine distance between two documents. Or in other words, they may ask you what is the cosine similarity between these two vectors. Now the vector A is having some numbers vector B is also having some another numbers, but the number of words, every number in this particular vector represents the frequency count of one word. 3 is representing one word. Similarly, the same time, same word appearing 10 times into document B. What is A and B here? A is document A, whereas B is also document which is representing document B, right? So document A has 6 words. Similarly, document B also has the same 6 words, but the number of times they are coming is different. So this 3 and 10 represent the frequency of that particular word. Suppose first word, maybe say greater is the word coming 3 times into document A, the same word appearing 10 times into document B. Similarly, some other words are there and their frequencies are there, right? So document A has the words count like 3, 8, 7, 5, 2 and 9. Similarly, document B has the word count as 10, 8, 6. Word count into it is 10, 8, 6, 6, 4, 5. And our job is to find the cosine distance between these two. In our previous lecture, we studied the formula of calculating the cosine distance. We are going to use the same formula in solve this example. How do you calculate the cosine similarity? The formula to calculate the cosine similarity is as follows. Cosine similarity is equals to the vector product of both the documents, that is document A and document B, or the vector product of two vectors divided by the Euclidean norm of document A or vector A into Euclidean norm of document B or vector B. It can also be represented like this: summation of I is to n AI into BI under divided by under root of again summation of I equal to 1 to n AI square into under root of summation of I equal to 1 to n BI square. So this is a general formula to calculate the cosine similarity between two vectors, where the values ranges between minus 1 to plus 1. Always this similarity range is in between minus 1 to plus 1, where minus 1, if it is the similarity measure, is shows that it is perfectly dissimilar documents. If your result is minus 1, suppose, then it shows that these two documents are perfectly dissimilar documents, whereas if your answer comes to 1, positive 1, then it is considered as both the documents are same. Both the documents are same, or both the vectors are same. Now if I put these values provided by to us in above vectors A and B here, A and B values are now, we'll put into the formula. So it becomes 3 into 10. Check first vector A and B's value. 3 into 10, then 8 into 8, 7 into 6, 5 into 6, 2 into 4, 5 into 9. We need to multiply these two vectors quantities. So all multiplication is done in the numerator, right? Divided by under root of, you need to find the square of each and every value provided into vector A. So AI square, A1 square plus A2 square plus A3 square and so on like this. So it becomes 3 square plus 8 square plus 7 square and so on till n square. All the values of vector A squared in the inside the under root. Similarly, we need to now multiply it with the another term, that is under root of all the values in the second document, second vector. 10 square plus 8 square plus 6 square and so on till last element is 5. So last is 5 square. Now if you solve this, you get some value, and that must be in the range of minus 1 to plus 1. Now if you see, the similarity value is obtained in this example is 0.8639. It is nearer to positive 1. This value is exactly near to positive 1. So we can say that these two documents are more similar to each other. Now I suppose I want to find what is the distance between two documents. I will apply the formula cosine distance equal to 1 minus similarity. Right. If I add two components, similarity component plus dissimilarity component, what I am going to get is the answer is 1. So to obtain cosine distance, I will use the formula 1 minus similarity of A comma B. Put the value here, 1 minus 0.8639. You will get the value as 0.1361. It means that the distance, now how these two documents are dissimilar, the factor is very less. If you see, it is very less. We can say that these two documents are more similar rather than that dissimilar, because we obtain the similarity measure at 0.8639, which is more closer to positive 1. So we can say that these two documents are more similar to each other.